Should I buy or should I rent? The decision to rent as opposed to buying is complex and requires some considerations. So let's get started. Hello everyone, Meral Ibrahim here, broker associate with Coldwell Banker Realty in the beautiful Palm Beaches, Florida. If you've been here before, thank you and welcome back. If you're new to my channel and want to learn about lifestyles, communities, and some real estate in South Florida, click on the subscribe button so you will be notified each time I make a video. Today, I'm excited to talk about renting versus buying a home, and there are pros and cons to each option. If you're starting to weigh your options, here are just a few questions you might need to consider as you decide whether to buy or rent. 1. Is it cheaper to buy or rent? There are different costs associated with renting versus buying, and it depends on where you live and the local housing market. Conventional wisdom is that renting is cheaper than buying a home, and that may have been true a number of years ago when mortgage rates were much higher. But that's no longer true today. The record low interest rates have brought the price of home ownership below the cost of renting the same property, especially since rents have been on the rise over the past couple of years. And even though home prices are rising faster than rents, home ownership is still more affordable. 2. Can I afford to buy? This is one of the leading questions on every potential home buyer's mind. And not just the affordability factor, but can you afford the home that will fit your lifestyle in the next few years? Or will a tight budget limit my options? It may make sense, more sense, to wait or rent for a while until you can get into a home that you can live in for some time or grow into with your family. But buying remains a sound financial decision for those with documented income and a good credit history. If you're still unsure, it may be helpful to talk with a real estate professional to help you answer and uncover questions about the cost of home ownership. 3. Is buying a home a sound investment? Buying a home has always been a staple of the American dream. You go to college, you get a job, you get married, you buy a house, and you have some kids. We can all agree that a good investment is something that makes money for you. And historically, a home purchase has proven to be one of the safest investments you can make. Homes typically appreciate in value over time while you build equity through monthly mortgage payments. If you anticipate staying in your home for only 1 or 2 years, it doesn't necessarily mean buying is not for you, but you are less likely to see a significant financial return on your investment. 4. Isn't renting easier than owning? It's true that when renting a home, any repairs or maintenance that needs to be done, the responsibility falls on the landlord. And while renting may seem like an easier option, the fundamental difference is, unlike equity built with each monthly mortgage payment, the rent that you pay is producing zero future financial benefit. And because home values generally go up over time, a home will ultimately provide return on your original investment. 5. How can I buy a house when there's so much competition? I think by now everyone knows about the multiple offers and bidding wars that takes the asking price thousands of dollars above the original asking price. It is a little crazy out there. Between low inventory and low interest rates, homes are getting swooped up at any cost. All the more reason to work with a seasoned real estate professional who knows how to navigate today's market. The overall cost of home ownership tends to be higher than overall cost of renting, even if the monthly mortgage payment is similar to or lower than the monthly rent. So as a homeowner, here are some expenses you'll be spending money on that you don't have to pay as a renter. Property taxes, water and sewer, repairs and maintenance, pest control, landscaping and tree trimming, homeowners insurance, pool service, lender required flood insurance. Even renovation projects don't often increase your home's value by more than what you invested in them. According to Remodeling Magazine, you'll get 66 cents for every dollar you spend on a home improvement project. There's no easy answer to the question, is it better to rent or better to buy? It depends on so many factors: your age, your finances, your neighborhood, your future plans, the current real estate market, the mortgage market. While buying a home still makes sense, becoming a homeowner before you're ready can have costly consequences. How much you have saved and how long you will stay in one place are the biggest factors in deciding whether you should rent or buy. My final thoughts: if you're financially ready and you find the right house, buy it. If you don't want to be a homeowner, rent. I hope you found this helpful if you're struggling with whether to rent or buy in your new city. And if you're looking to buy or sell in South Florida, reach out to me. I'm happy to help. And check out this video for tools to research neighborhoods that you may be considering. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button and bell so you'll be notified of my new videos. Thank you for joining me, and see you next time. Bye.